Hey guys, welcome to the second instalment of Race Result Tech Check. Today we want to talk about the Race Result folding ground antenna. As the first company to produce a folding ground antenna, we not only have a patent on it, but with more than 100 units in our rental stock going in and out every week, we know a thing or two about how to take care of them. In its standard configuration, our folding mat is 4.8 meters. That's 8 segments of 60 centimeters with a total weight of 27 kilograms. If you need a shorter mat, then you can either disconnect the unused elements, and we recommend starting from antenna number 1 because it's less antennas to open up and take off, or you can simply fold the unused antennas at the side of the road. If you do this, however, you shouldn't connect the cables of any antennas which aren't actually reading. Not only is it a waste of read time, as we call it, but it also causes negative impact on your system. Remember that return loss warning we talked about in the last video? This is the number one cause of that. For setups longer than 4.8 meters, we offer either 6 meter or 8 meter extension kits, which include empty mats, dummy antennas, and longer cables for the 8 meter kit to distribute the antennas evenly across the length of the mat. If you are using dummy antennas in this configuration, you shouldn't use any shoe or ankle worn transponders, since there is a chance of dead zones between the antennas at particularly low height. You can also join two or more mats in the middle with a decoder on either side of the road. However, if you are doing this, disconnect one of the antennas or have a dummy antenna between them so there's always space. Remember, a chip can only talk to one reader at any time. If you're using 8 meter mats, actually take one of these out so there's only one space between them to maximize your read zone. For European customers, you also need to set the frequency of your reader to A and B. Again, making sure a chip is only in the field of one frequency at any one time. The final rule applies to those of you who like keeping your mats in that 8 meter configuration. Remember that the highest density of antennas is in the middle of the mat, so try and keep this centered on the road, folding up the unused antennas on either side of the road. When designing the mats, we had a few major challenges to face. One of these was how to make a mat that was small enough and light enough to be transported easily, but heavy enough to stay on the road with thousands of runners running across, and strong enough to withstand being driven by even the largest of trucks. Thanks to the material chosen, the mats themselves are incredibly strong and extremely hard to damage. We also ensured that any weight in the mats was laid down on the road, not rolling about with extra weight for carrying or storage. When folding and unfolding your mat, try and take care of the hinges between them. Try not to twist the mat, as this can actually damage them. When unfolding your mat, pull it straight out when you're unfolding it. If you do need to move it, then try not to twist it sideways from one end. Again, this can damage the hinges. And when you're folding the mat back up, we recommend standing at one end, pulling the mat towards you as you fold it up. For those of you looking for something stronger, we also offer our aluminium hinges. But beware, if you use these on uneven ground, it can damage the mat elements themselves. Speaking of uneven ground, try and clear any large debris from underneath the mat, such as rocks and stones, and your mat should fit pretty nicely on pretty much any surface. The other part to take care of is the antenna cables themselves. Try not to pull the cables too hard or drag the mat by the cables, as this can damage the cable and the antenna itself. When you're transporting or storing mats, take care of the cables and keep them from getting squashed. We normally stack ours on the side so the cables can't be squashed by any weight on top. Believe it or not, squashed B and C connectors don't go on very easily. The good news is all of this was considered during the design of the antennas. All of the parts are actually serviceable. The antennas, cables, mats themselves can all be interchanged really easily and are readily available in our shop for you to buy. Or you can email our support team and speak to them about what you actually need. It's actually a good idea to service your antennas regularly as well, by opening them up and checking inside. We use a biodegradable lubricant inside the mats before shipping, so you can give them a quick spray every time you open them. This helps to make sure the lids go back on nice and flush and stay closed. One final word of advice: if you are using the trolley that came with our mats, Do note these were designed to carry one 8-meter mat, not two mats and their decoders. Believe it or not, they'll break. Yep, we know you tried. You know who you are. Anyway, that's all from me for today. Thank you very much for tuning in. See you next time.